Chaired by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, the August Assembly has considered and passed two bills, the Public Finance Management Amendment Bill of 2021 and the Income Tax Amendment Bill of 2021, to domesticate and operationalize oil agreements, which Uganda has signed with other states and oil companies to facilitate commercial oil production.
Attorney General, you're such a wonderful person. We've been able to pass the Income Tax Amendment Number 2, 2021, and then the Public Finance Management Act, Bill 2021. And as we pass these bills, we leave it now to you, Executive.
I think it's a nice method of work, Madam Speaker, and I want to congratulate you. We are not legislating for ourselves. I was very happy when I heard Honorable Kivumbi or someone else, that we are legislating for generations. This resource we are talking about, some of us may not even see much about it.
Whereas government in its initial proposal had sought exclusive powers for UNOC to spend money at source, it has been rejected by Parliament on grounds that it would usurp Parliament's appropriation mandate. They rather recommended having UNOC's cash calls scrutinized from time to time and not follow the normal budget cycle.
With much emphasis on oil production, we have agreed that the oil company retains revenue to help it in processing, in doing its business. Most people thought that the Parliament would first approve before they do it, but today we said they can retain the money, then Parliament comes in to approve within 15 days, so that it is a win-win situation.
We do know that the Ugandan law doesn't allow any government agency to spend at source. Money should be put in one account such that whoever wants to access it comes to Parliament, seeks appropriation, and is given money as per the budget.
Although Parliament has allowed UNOC to retain a portion of petroleum revenue and spend at source, the lawmakers are to approve the budget estimates submitted by Uganda National Oil Company within 15 days. Should Parliament fail to clear UNOC in 15 days, it will take as mandatory approval.
The substance was about, can UNOC get money to enable it to do business in the oil sector? The answer is yes. Today what we have passed gives UNOC a leeway to get adequate resources it requires to meet its obligations under the production sharing agreements already entered into, and all other relevant oil laws.
Parliament has also passed the Income Tax Amendment Bill of 2021 to introduce windfall tax on windfall gains of oil companies.
There are minimum and maximum prices set under which tax is levied. But there are times when there is a boom and you go beyond the predetermined price. This is how the windfall arises.
The petroleum agreement introduced windfall tax, which is new in our economy, and it had no provision in the existing law. So we had to create provisions that accept that tax, which is in good faith. And it is in that faith that we amended the Income Tax Act, and we had no problem with government amendments.